He was caught in the hotel with strippers, that she beat up the strippers, and that he ended up threatening to kill her. That one time he was high on coke and he was beyond paranoid in his man cave and started making holes in the walls, and he thought there was microphones in the walls, and that Chloe was worried, so she called one of her friends, and that she came down to knock on the door and he grabbed her by her shoulders and screamed at her saying, "You're trying to embarrass me in front of my friends, I'll effing kill you, you don't know what I'm capable of." So this was a man that has a lot of deep psychological issues, and those issues not being addressed is what led to 2015, where he was found in the brothel in Nevada and he was hospitalized. It was reported that he overdosed, and at the hospital they reported he had 12 seizures and 6 strokes. But today I saw a report where he alleged that he felt as though Dennis Hoff, who was the owner of the brothel, tried to poison him. So it's no telling what exactly occurred. All in all I hope is that Black women take away from this situation is that Lamar is not really paying homage to her. Actually, it's disrespectful to me. This is a man that has been with multiple women. He had a woman that he was dating for many years, and he had other side chicks. He brought Taraji into that mix. He brought all these other women into this situation. He could have gave Taraji incurable diseases. He could have gotten her killed, because some women are demented and will kill over a man. He put her in so much danger, and now it's like, well, she's the only Black woman I think I ever deeply loved. It's like, who cares? I understand he has a memoir, but it's like too little too late. I'm sick of some Black men like Lamar Odom when their white wives leave them, or all these other races of women aren't really checking for them because they see that he's mentally unstable or whatever other issues he may have going on. Now he wants to profess his love to this Black woman, and it's like, eh. The part that gets me the most is to see how damaged Chloe viewed him as, and I feel like him being with her only made that worse, to the point that she was even faking trying to conceive with him instead of just being honest. But she was so detached from him because of his ways, and again, I didn't want that for Taraji or any Black woman at all. Let Chloe and those like her have to deal with men like that. I'm thankful that Taraji did not end up getting pregnant by him. I'm thankful that she left at the time she did, because sometimes these men swirling and not even wanting to date Black women is a blessing in disguise, because look at all the turmoil they will put you through. They will make you single mothers. They will leave you broke. They will leave you lonely. They will leave you destitute. They will leave you mentally fragile, and all because they have these fetishes. They don't address these fetishes that they have for lighter skin or non-Black women in general. I feel like narcissism is at an all-time high in the Black community, and some people just view it as, oh well, it's just a person that's full of themselves. You guys need to really look deep into that, and a lot of these men who are entertainers, they fit that bill of the narcissistic male, and you have to beware of them. Men that try to get you to get pregnant real fast, you need to be careful that he may be trying to trap you. They say that, oh yeah, you know, women try to trap a man. I feel like in some cases these men will try to trap you so that they can always have you to come back to, and it's sad that some of our men will do this to us, where they'll blaze the trail with all of the races of women, and then finally they'll wake up and come to their senses like, oh well, I love Black women now and now I want to come back to you guys. No, the comeback male should be a non-existent factor in the Black community, especially with Black women. Sometimes I feel like with Black women, we still readily accept men like a Lamar Odom. We readily accept men who have rejected us in their prime, and they know they can crawl back into the arms of a Black woman, and you have to cut men like that off. Lamar Odom to me is not in any position to be dating any woman, and specifically I pray on everything that he does not date a Black woman. I need y'all to send a memo to all Black women across the world: do not date a Lamar Odom, and do not date men who have their qualities, because they're going to be energy vampires just sucking you of everything that you can provide to them. Some of these men are broken beyond repair, and that's something I feel like some of us become addicted to, is trying to fix these men. And I used to be the same way. A man has something wrong with him, I would be like, oh yeah, I could fix him, I could help him. And it's like, no, don't waste your time trying to fix somebody that have irreparable damage. Does that mean you should just give up on somebody that you're currently in a relationship with when you love them? I don't think so. But when a person already comes with all this baggage, you got kids over here, kids over there, women over here, you got them guzzling abortion pills like a Skittle, this ain't Taste the Rainbow, bitch. You doing drugs, you thinking microphones is in the wall. It's like, that's too much, I feel like, for us to bear as Black women. And just be grateful again that nothing transpired way past just a dating relationship with him and Taraji. And please, Black women, stay away from men like Lamar. Trust me, the money is not worth it. So let me know what you guys feel about Taraji and Lamar's dating relationship. Did you know about his girlfriend Liza Morales? Did you know that he dated Taraji in the past? Please make sure you like, comment, subscribe, and share, and I'll talk to you guys in my next video. Bye.